you need to understand that you have an outer self and an inner self. The outer self is your fake self, the self that you think you are, the fake personalities that you think you are. The outer self is the self you need to act in front of the world, to put out a drama. This outer self is your mask, but you end up thinking this is your real self. It is not. It is just on the surface, your outer self, your fake self. And then there is your inner self, which is your true self. If you are associated only with your outer self, then life will become a cyclone. There will be constant conflict, constant turmoil, constant struggle, misery, suffering. But all this suffering is only on the surface. Just as on the surface of the ocean, there are waves. But this is not all that there is to life. Deep down is your inner self. Deep down is your center, where there is no conflict. It is silent. It is soundless. This center is your inner self, your true self. In this center, life is a noiseless flow, relaxed. A river moving with no struggle, no misery, no suffering, no sadness, no depression. You need to find this inner center of yours. It is very easy for you to get identified with your outer self, the surface. But then only anxiety and anguish will follow. This is what has happened with everybody. We are identified with the surface and the struggles that go on there. The surface, your fake self, the outer self, is bound to be disturbed. There is nothing wrong in it. But if you can be rooted in the center, then this disturbance that is on the surface can become beautiful. This suffering can become beautiful. Then all this drama that is going on will just become a game to be played. It'll just become a play. All these techniques of yoga and meditation is just to get you in touch with your center, with your inner self, to move within, to forget the surface, to leave the surface for time being and relax into your own self and relax into your inner being so deeply that the outer self disappears and only the inner self remains. The problem is your mind goes on clinging to your outer self, to the surface. Relaxing into your inner self is not the problem. The mind clinging to the outer self is the problem. You go on clinging to the outer self because you are afraid that if you leave the outer self, you might get lost. But in reality, clinging to your outer self, you get lost. There is nothing to be afraid of because deep down, there is darkness and you cannot see anything else other than your outer self, your fake self. There is nothing to be afraid of. That which looks dark and bottomless is actually the ground of your being. You need to understand, once you leave your fake self, the surface, your outer self, only then you can be centered. This centering is the aim. Once you are centered, then you can move to the outer self. Then you can play with this drama of the world. But if you get into this drama without being centered, then you will get lost and confused. Being centered and then getting involved in the drama makes you a master, because then you are not actually involved in the drama. You just silently watch. Remaining centered is beautiful. All your struggles that you thought were struggles will just become a play for you. Then there is no conflict. It is a game. Then it will not create tension within you. No anxiety, no anguish. And any moment life becomes too heavy, too hard, then you can go back to your original source where there is only relaxation. Then you can be refreshed, rejuvenated, recharged. And then you can move back to your outer self again. Then there is no suffering, no misery anymore. It is very easy once you know the way. And the way is not too long. And you are not going anywhere else than into your own self. That is why it is not long. It is very near. The only barrier is your holding on to the outer self, to your fake self, afraid that if you leave it, you will be lost. This fear feels almost as if you are going to die. Moving to your inner center is a death. Death of all your suffering, death of all your misery, all your anguish, all your sadness, all your troubles. This is nothing but a total relaxation into yourself. You are always tense, and that is because of the clinging, the holding on to the surface, to your outer self. You are never relaxed, never in a state of let go. Even while you sleep, you remain partially relaxed. Even in your sleep, you go on manipulating. You do not allow everything to happen. Watch a man sleeping. You will see he is very tense. His whole body will be tense. And watch a child sleeping. He will be so relaxed. Or watch an animal, a cat. A cat is so relaxed while sleeping. You are not relaxed even while sleeping. You are tense, struggling, moving, fighting with something. On your face, there is tension. In your dreams, you may be fighting, protecting, doing the same things when you are awake, repeating them in an inner drama, but you are not relaxed. You are not in a deep let go. And that is why sleep has become more and more difficult. Psychologists say that if this trend goes on, then there will come a day where nobody will be able to sleep naturally. Sleep will have to be chemically induced because nobody will be able to sleep naturally. This day is not very far. You are already on your way towards it, because even when you are asleep, you are partially asleep, partially relaxed. Meditation is the deepest sleep. It is complete relaxation plus something more. You are completely relaxed plus alert. Awareness is there. If you know how to relax, then nothing can disturb you. If you don't know how to relax, then everything will disturb you. You are almost always ready to be disturbed. If one thing doesn't disturb you, then something else will. You have a tendency to be disturbed. If all the causes are withdrawn from you, even then you will get disturbed. If you do not know how to relax, you will find some cause, you will create some cause. You will create some thought, some idea, and then get disturbed, then get worried. Once you know how to relax, then nothing can disturb you. It's not that the world will change. It's not that things will be different. The world will be the same. But you don't have the tendency. You don't have the madness to be disturbed. You are not constantly ready to be disturbed. Then all that happens around you is soothing. Even the traffic noise is soothing. If you are relaxed, it depends on you. It is an inner quality. The more you go towards the center, your inner self, your true self, the more this quality of relaxation arises. And the more you go towards the outer, the surface, your fake self, your outer self, the more this quality of getting disturbed arises. If you are too disturbed, if you are too worried, tensed, in anguish, in pain, this just means that you are very close to your outer self, your fake self. You need to understand that your real home is at the center, your inner being, your true self. You need to understand that when you are relaxed, beautiful ideas arise. Earning your livelihood doesn't become a problem anymore. Relationships do not become a problem anymore. Your mind, your thoughts, overthinking, anguish, pain, all this doesn't happen to you anymore. You need to know how to relax. If you're always tensed, always disturbed, nothing will work in your favor, because you yourself are not in your control.